But I think that our teams are about ready to go here for the finals. Again, that is going to be Church of Mel versus Team C. There is no brawl involved in this, so the picks are starting right now.
And, you know, Church of Mal, I guess, has the one advantage that they got to see all of C's last match against Brawl. And I wonder what they're thinking because, you know, are they going to ban Nightmare Superman? Or are they going to, you know, ban Wonder Woman? Because both those champions were pretty instrumental for C's victories in those games, I feel like.
I think you're definitely right. And despite the fact that we know how good Cao is on Wonder Woman, Brawl still let the Wonder Woman pick go through. And that was a bit surprising to me. And it looks like we're already going to start off with an Atomic Green Lantern ban from Team C.
Yeah, and I think that's a solid ban because if you're thinking Atomic Green Lantern is such a strong top lane champion, but Cao has such a deep roster the champion can pull from, they'd rather ban ones that would make their opponents uncomfortable because he knows, I mean, worst case, he'll pick, you know, he can pick Aquaman, who knows. But he's got Nightmare Superman, he's got Wonder Woman, he's got API, he's got a lot of, he's got a very deep roster in that top lane, so it's hard to ban against him.
And it looks like Atomic Wonder Woman banned out for Church of Mal, right back into an Arcane Green Lantern ban for Team C.
Yeah, the Atomic Wonder Woman's kind of almost a no-brainer ban. You don't want to let that one slide through. You saw what happened when Brawl got Atomic Wonder Woman.
Yeah, so. Pretty good. You know, used in every kill up until about the 17-minute mark and controlled the pace of the game, so not bad. Our teams were joking around a little bit saying that, you know, Atomic Wonder Woman apparently is still a pretty good pick. Gas Joker is the last ban there for Team Out, and that's immediately into an insta-lock on Harley Quinn for Team C.
You know what's interesting is, out of the bans, three of the bans are really champions that are most often played in the top lane.
Mm-hmm.
And so that means that the top lane players are going to have to really dig into their deeper rosters. I mean, you're still Wonder Woman and Tom Poison and Ivy are two pretty common ones. But for Church of Mal, I don't really know Nick's roster as well as I know Cao's. I've seen him play some Atrocitus before, so we could see...
That's what I was curious.
Yeah.
Because I'm not sure what else is going to be there. I like that they're grabbing the Nightmare Superman away. They're like, no. Wow! All right, so not only are they going to go for the Nightmare Superman, but they are actually going to go for the Wonder Woman pick as well. Now, Cao probably doesn't have to pick an Enforcer until the end. Now, of course, he can wait and just see and counterpick. We saw him play Atomic Poison Ivy in the first game against Brawl. He got bullied.
He got bullied by
Gas Joker and Atomic Wonder Woman.
And so it's hard to tell. Was that because he's not as practiced with Tom Poison Ivy, or was it because they let both Gas Joker and Atomic Wonder Woman go to Brawl, who are two champions you normally don't want to let slide through? So we'll have to see if he goes with that or if he goes something different. They are getting Joker and Atomic Joker. And every time Sotura's gone Atomic Joker, it's gone pretty poorly for the other team.
It has. And Atomic Joker and Harley Quinn combination is just crazy. The range plus sustain you have down there is amazing. You can make favorable trades all day long, even against ganks and stuff like that if they end up popping up. Picks are going super quick, though. Right back on Church of Mal's side, we had a very quick lock-in of both Flash and Zatanna. So once again, taking Flash away from Mistygen.
And I feel like Zatanna may go, either Zatanna or Nightmare Superman, I think will go to the mid lane with Azure Fire.
Mm-hmm.
He does like to sometimes play controllers in that mid lane, and they can be pretty scary. We'll see how I'm going pro, assuming he'll be mid lane again for a C, deals with it with Joker, because it's Joker is such a versatile mid laner, but he doesn't have the free poke that's consistent that Nightmare Superman or Zatanna have with their just constant harass.
Yeah, I mean, and that's the advantages that I'm Going Pro was able to get on Joker whenever he did play him, was largely due to the fact that he was going up against Star Sapphire, and he just sat there and out-traded all day long. Just sat there, out-traded not just in terms of auto attacks, but also in terms of just picking up drone kills and things like that. So, all right. Wow, okay. Interesting pick still coming in. We have a Nightmare Robin, it looks like, as the final pick for Team C, and an Atrocitus in there as well. That's what Cao's going to be on.
Yeah, and the Nightmare Robin's pretty interesting because in the past they picked Batman when they couldn't get Flash or Atomic Wonder Woman. Nightmare Robin is more of a champion that's very popular in Europe, but it will be interesting to see how... probably going to be Mistygen in the jungle gun, how he does with Nightmare Robin, because he's a champion that can be really scary, but you gotta land his combos just right. And sometimes it's very hard against a team that's also fighting back and throwing different things at you.
Yeah, we saw Dignitas before in the EU finals play him to great success. They did have the positioning, and when they did, he just came in and wrecked face. And it looks like Maestro is going to pick up Green Arrow as his marksman of choice.
He really likes that Green Arrow, mm-hmm. and Green Arrow Nightmare Superman can really bully a lane quite well. I think that definitely the aggressive power in the bottom lane will go to Church of Mao. The one thing that's nice about the Harley Quinn Atomic Joker combination, though, is even if they're not going to really bully their lane so much, they might be able to. But the real strength of pairing Harley Quinn Atomic Joker is that she's so good at keeping her lane mate alive, and Atomic right. Joker doesn't have that escape. So he needs the heals and the hammers to basically keep people off him until he gets to that stage, or, you know, basically once he hits level 6, if they try to get him, he just pops his ultimate, then.
I mean, but honestly, even if they get pushed into tower consistently or something like that, all they have to do is sit back, auto-attack, and farm. And with the sustain of Harley Quinn, they're going to be fine. I mean, they have to watch out for ganks, obviously. As you mentioned, it's not exactly like Atomic Joker gets away from fights pretty easily. So they're going to have to watch out for ganks. But, I mean, honestly, they can probably out-trade about any bottom lane that they come up against.
Yeah, they have the advantage of Harley Quinn having a heal, and Nightmare Superman only has shields, right. No heal. And I think their real power is going to be kind of playing it maybe a little more slower until they get level 6. Mm-hmm. And then if you combine Harley Quinn's ultimate with like Nightmare Robin coming in there at the same time and Atomic Joker's damage output when he gets 6, it's going to be pretty scary. That's going to be their real time to shine.
All right, so here we have it, ladies. Hand side of the map, we have Team C. On the right-hand side of the map, we have Church of Mal. And there's Cowan as Atrocitus.
You know, smashing his fists together, getting a little pumped up, ready to go into top lane. I don't think I've seen Kyle play Atrocitus before. He's a scary top laner. I mean, he's a big dude with lots of red skin. You can see he's eager for action.
It's really all you need, by the way. So.
Yes. Yes. Big muscles, red skin, and eager for action, and you're good to go.
It's still going to be odd, though, with a lot of our very common top laners knocked out of this game, though, you know? I mean, it's been a mainstay. We've had an Atomic Green Lantern, I believe, in every single game up to this point. We've had Wonder Woman, when she isn't banned, she's been involved in the game. And, of course, Gas Joker, we saw absolutely dominate.
Oh, it looks like there was something needs to be a regame for some reason, maybe a player disconnected or something. So we'll try to figure out what really went on with that and see what's going on, because obviously that wasn't a legitimate surrender. There was an error with the game.
You're kidding me. They didn't surrender at 0 seconds. I'm shocked. But guys, yeah, of course, we are going to get that going here in just a second. Couple of notes for you all, though. Of course, if you want to be involved in Infinite Crisis Esports, you can get involved in these competitions. Please check out nationalesl.com. You can click on that Infinite Crisis option. Don't forget as well, if you want to check out the game just in general, head on over to infinitecrisis.com. Sign up. Join us. It is super fun. And you can possibly be playing for these thousands and thousands of dollars as well. We have $1,000 for first place, though, out of this finals match. This is, of course, a best of three, so first team to two wins will take home the monthly tournament. And looks like we're ready, so we're going to jump back into it. Obviously, we're just going to fly through the picks again. They'll be taking the exact same picks and bans.
Yeah, so we're just going to restart in blind pick mode. Apparently, there was just a little bit of a glitch with someone's amplifier set not loading properly, and so they didn't actually get any of their amplifiers.
What?
So we're...
I don't think that'll help.
No. So, of course, we're going to re-go. We're going to skip the draft. Everyone's picking the exact same champions. You can see it's going to go quite fast as everyone readies up. We're just waiting for Mistagen to click that ready. There he goes, and should be starting in a few seconds here. I'm actually pretty excited to see Atrocitus, because he's one of those guys that, like you said, I don't think we've seen him yet today. Mm. And it'll be interesting, because he's very powerful, but he doesn't have an insanely like single high-impact moment like a Wonder Woman would.
Right.
But he also just kind of is all-around really strong. He's much stronger for ganks than Wonder Woman, just because he has a slow that's also an auto-attack reset, so it's slow and damage.
Right.
And he can kind of taunt people back towards him.
What I like is that you just don't get him out of fights. He just plants himself and he goes, I'm here. You have to deal with me. There's no trickery. I'm not going to do anything crazy. I'm not going to instantly knock down anyone on your team or anything like that. But you have to deal with me. You have to get me off here. The slows are going to kill your team.
And he's one of the most damaging enforcers. As far as he doesn't have quite the same level of crowd control, but he has a lot of damage, especially once he gets a couple items. So you see players build off like a cosmic staff on him to boost that damage up a bit. And we'll have to see how Kyle likes to play him, because I think that could be something that's very important. Is Kyle's going to be looking to probably try to really dominate that top lane for his team and make sure that Nick is really underfed and unable to contribute into mid and later parts of the game. And at the same time, I don't know what Church of Mal can do. Like, if Kyle starts getting ahead in top lane, I don't know what Church of Mal can do to stop him, really, because I don't see Flash messing with Atrocitus.
No, not really. And I'm trying to take a look and see what hero powers, stolen powers they have and things like that. All right, so, I mean, there's only one teleport that's sitting there for both of our top laners. But, yeah, I mean, Wonder Woman is going to have pretty decent chase potential. I mean, it's so, like, they, I would assume, have to gank it maybe a little bit early and just try and snowball the lane right away.
Yeah. If you get Atrocitus early, that's when he's vulnerable. But, I mean, that can go both ways, too, with Nightmare Rob and Flash. The problem is Flash is not particularly strong at levels 1 through 4, pretty much. We'll see how it plays out. I mean, Mecha Alfred's really, really good in the jungle, and I've seen him explode a lot. But actually, already, Nick's taking some damage on this harass here.
Wow, yeah, and Cal's just going to continue moving up, so trades about a third health for about a sixth health there, so goes in favor of Atrocitus. And, of course, he's just going to keep building up that rage, and so he'll eventually be able to overwhelm this lane. But this is going to be a very physical lane, and it doesn't look like Wonder Woman can trade right now.
No, already having to use a lot of vials there. Notice that Cal started with the nil weapon as opposed to the nil cloak, so you can tell he's really intending to be very aggressive in lane, whereas I think Nick's just going to try to survive. But it's hard because Kyle's just going to try to freeze the lane. He's going to deny, you know, any credits towards Nick just by stopping him as soon as they go down.
But that's fine, though. I mean, Wonder Woman doesn't have to get the most damage done at the beginning of games. We saw a very passive game, and actually where Kyle was bullied as Wonder Woman in the last game for a little bit, and then hit 6 and then just started dominating, so.
Well, it looks like he's going to try to bait out some damage, and here comes Misogyn. Trying to get in on Nick, but unable to do too much more than just her ass.
Right. But, you know, denies a little bit more experience, denies a little bit more credits there, and Atrocitus does gain a bit of an advantage. 1,000 credits right now to the 889 for Wonder Woman. Down here in bot lane, as we mentioned before, this lane from Church of Mal has the potential to do some serious damage. Just between poke, if Kaedas and Satura aren't ready for it, they can get poked to death. The problem is, though, is that basically any damage they do to Maestro or Picasso is permanent. I mean, it's as you mentioned before, we've got a shield for Nightmare Superman, sure, that's fine, but they don't really have a way to sustain themselves in lane.
Yeah, so they're gonna have to make sure that they can see out damage Hardy's heals, which is easier easier than it was before Wednesday, as the will cost of those heals has been increased. But it's still a significant advantage Hardy has, and actually Satura is really naining a lot of those hot potatoes onto Maestro, dishing out a ton of damage.
That's just what I was going to say. I mean, he has kept Maestro at half health or under this entire time, and Maestro's kind of sitting there and passively getting experience, but he can't even get close enough to auto-attack the drones right now.
Yeah, and that's going to be a problem for Church of Mal, because they're the ones who probably want to be putting a little more pressure early into the game, and then, you know, maybe worrying once Nightmare Robin gets near, once they're vulnerable. But the fact that they're kind of losing out these trades at this point is not really the best sign for them.
No, not at all. And once again, Satura just continues to sit in there and do damage. Pretty effective. And it looks like we missed a trade up top. Cal went a little bit ham there and almost gets Nick for his troubles.
Yeah, and that's going to force Nick out of the lane and kind of slow him and starve him down a little bit more. Very bloody top lane is. Cal Zeffy trying to be extremely assertive with his Atrocitus, and that means that both sides probably have a lot of opportunities for the junglers to come in and make some kills. But right now, They're both more focused in his bottom lane.
Yeah, Nightmare Robin reveals himself. He's not really going to get a whole lot done here. It looks like I'll make him Alfred there.
He's just one punch.
I know, just walks up and is just like, get out of here. Punches him in the face.
Maybe it was a high five. He was trying to give Joker a high five. It's hard to tell there.
That was a really nasty high five.
It was. There was a lot more intent behind it. He didn't use any skills, though, just the basic. And actually, he's coming up behind Cal. This could be bad news for Cal. He's a little ahead of Nick, but there goes Psychic Assault.
Yeah, so Cow takes a huge amount of damage. He's down to just a few hit points left. He's about to get to his turret. Do they have enough damage? They get to the side, and they do. And that's exactly what Wonder Woman needed. Had Atrocitus been able to just keep bullying her out of lane, that damage would have built, and there would have been no chance of recovery for Wonder Woman. But now that that gank is there, she can come back and equalize a bit.
And that's one of the things you have to be really careful of. If you're playing a really aggressive lane, just trying to bully and kind of boss your opposing lane member around, you have to realize that both of you are going to be really vulnerable to ganks, and so whichever team is better able to exploit that is definitely going to pick up a couple kills, and right now let's stretch them out.
That's right, Maestro is really being bullied at the moment down here. I mean, he has been able to do virtually nothing, and now I know the credits aren't that far different between our players down in bot lane, but he has just been rendered fairly ineffective at being able to do any damage in trades.
Well, we've seen Misogyn really focus on counter jungling a lot. And now, wow, that was a good trade to Azure Fire, although I'm going pro is taking some damage himself as well. And we can see Cal here, maybe angry at Flash, tries to push him out of the jungle a bit, and then he's going to go back to lane. But all that work he put himself in getting ahead of Wonder Woman with that, you know, that first blood on him, actually, he's definitely now behind by a couple hundred.
Yeah, down by a few hundred credits right now. That does give an itemization advantage to Wonder Woman for now. And like we said, you know, this game changes around, or that lane changes around a lot when she hits level 6 as well. If Atrocitus decides to go in too deep, she can blocking bracers under turret for additional damage if she needs it. She can hold people in place very efficiently for her jungler to catch up. Although I think Flash is all the way down bot looking to pressure, so not going to be able to get a whole lot done there.
Yeah, we did see Misogyn come with Nightmare Robin try to put some damage on Wonder Woman, but he actually took the must work worse hedge of that trade as he missed his little scythe blades, and then of course without that first part of the combo, Nightmare Robin is not extremely effective if he's unable to land as that
And Mecha Malfred is getting surrounded, but not before he's able to grab the larger of the drones there.
Saw Azure Fire there get a little speed boost to help me get away.
Yeah, very nice there. Apparently excellent fashion sense as well, so. Okay, so mostly due to the fact that Team C's been not present in this lane for a little while, Churchamal did a nice job of pushing this up, and Maestro is actually starting to farm some gold now. He was pretty far behind in this game, but is actually even things up to a fair degree. Yeah, he's actually about 50 gold ahead, or 50 credits ahead right now.
And all those little small advantages add up, and looks like Cal is back onto his aggressive track, trying to force Nick out of lane. Even though Churchamal did get first bloods, he's already been able to equalize those credits, and I think it's just due to stronger lanes. I mean, Cal's 200 credits ahead, or a little over 100 credits ahead of Nick, even though that Nick got first blood in him. And he's just being extremely aggressive with that Atrocitus.
Yeah, absolutely. And I like that. I mean, I think he has to play the role of bully a little bit. And if he can keep that lane really, really pushed into his opponent's turrets as well, when he's not worried about getting credits, he can actually start drifting down to bottom lanes and putting on pressure as well and just trying to overwhelm. All right, it looks like Team C is actually going to do a little bit of damage here to Picasso. Maestro taking some damage on the way out. And Satura, of course, takes a bomb, blows up, does a little bit of damage. He's all right, though.
See, Misogyn's been trying to find an opportunity to do damage. He just has level 6 now, and actually, this could be really bad for Mecha Alfred. I don't think he saw him.
No, neither do I. He's going to continue going for this. Misogyn's got to move in soon, and does he get it? No, Mecha Alfred ended up picking it up, but he may pay with his life. There comes the ult from Flash, and he sneaks out of there, and it doesn't look like there's any potential for Misogyn to catch back up. Oh, but no. They're going to go on Maestro.
Yes, and I think he already used it. No, he saved his ultimate for Maestro, but it wasn't quite enough to finish off the kill. Maybe a hot potato bounce off Picasso. No, another Blood Hunt. But here comes Mecha Alfred back in the picture. So Tura, is going to try to pick up this kill, and barely misses it.
Yeah, the shield comes in from Nightmare Superman right away, and Satura has to back off. So in the end, this is going to turn into a 1v1, but a very kind of crazy, sloppy fight there from both sides. Really thought that was going to end up being a 2-for-1 or something like that.
Yeah, incredibly bloody, with many people getting extremely low on life. Somehow, it ended up basically dead even as both bin laders came in there, but kind of countered each other with neither of them really being able to provide too much support as the all the little skirmishy mode was done by that time.
And looks like I'm going pro throws up Mr. Punchy, just to check and make sure no one's sitting there and waiting around the corner for him. Of course he's not. Cow, though, is what is this lane actually looking like now? So 2,500 credits to 2,300 credits, so he has regained the advantage ever so slightly. And despite the fact that kills are in favor of Church of Mal at the moment, they are still down by 400 credits overall. So a little bit better job by Team C of just running objectives.
Yeah, C's just been stronger in lane, even though I feel like Church of Mal's had better ganks and better traps and better setups. And here comes another one, Nick trying to bait in Cal, but Cal realized something was up and will be enough though. Actually, there's an ultimate from Nick.
Yeah, and Cow turned around. He tried to throw up on the rest of Church of Mal, but it wasn't enough. And another successful gank. Church of Mal does tie things up. They're actually ahead by about 200 credits now. This bottom lane is the one that's a bit of a weird thing for me, because Church of Mal has been bullied out, and they've lost essentially every trade in this lane, just in terms of damage to champions at this point. But what they have done a really good job of is continuing to push very aggressively as soon as Kaithis or Satura leave lane. Like, as soon as they do, they've repushed this lane back up to their opponent's turret, and they're taking objectives in their jungle. So that's how they've been able to keep some sort of parity here. And it looks like Atrocitus is going to move in. Maestro may pay the price for it. He gets a shield from Nightmare Superman, and he does back out of there. Crazy. And Picasso keeps that alive. Well, here comes Mecha Malfred.
Oh, there goes the second assault on Sotura, trying to finish him off. A few more basics might do it, but Mecha Malfred gets sucked in by Cal. He's forced to use his ultimate just to stay alive. But Cal just punches him, but here's an ultimate from Picasso. That maybe again neutralized a 1-for-1 trade.
Another 1-for-1 trade. And in the top lane, it looks like Wonder Woman was actually forced to back. So Team C was actually able to move that up. And here comes Joker. Very nice job. He snags one kill. Can he get any more in the middle of this? No, it looks like he's actually going to pay the price for it. Going to try and escape top, but already Nightmare Superman was coming around. Pretty decent juking so far, but now he's a rabbit, and now he's dead.
So again, it's just very even in these kills, blow for blow between these two teams. I guess it seems like the main theme here is all these plays for both sides have been opened up by Cal basically bullying his lane.
Right.
Because it's opened up him being vulnerable for ganks from Nick and Flash, Mecha Malfred combined. But at the same time, when he pushes the lane, what he's able to do is he's able to use that teleport to support his other lane. So he's basically playing the top laner and the jungler for his team at the same time, and it's kind of working out okay. And they just need Misogyn to kind of come in there and actually make some moves of his own as well.
It's kind of working out okay, I agree with you, but Nick is starting to get really strong. Nick has now hit level 8. I believe there's still a credit disparity there probably amongst the two players. Let's see, 3250 to 30. Okay, so it's not actually all that much. But Wonder Woman's going to get very strong now and is kind of going a little bit under the radar. Does she actually have teleport up as well, out of curiosity? Yes, so she'll be able to react to react to a fight. If she tries to get Kao to like really engage top, they could set up a gank bot and she could teleport.
Yeah, and here we see a Jurifier coming down. This could be one of those teleport moments. There's a camera there. They were definitely thinking about it. But no, Nyx is going right back to the lane.
Yeah, and I think all he has to do here is show himself a little bit, and Azurifier's taking a huge amount of damage. She dies right away. Picasso and Maestro not going to be able to do anything from around the side, and Team C continues to push their way up. Very, very nice grab there, and they're up 500 credits.
And that's exactly what C needed. They need to have Nightmare Robin make some plays, because they can't rely on the rest of the team all the time. But actually, look at this, Mecha Malfred going in very deep. Pops his ultimate to stay alive.
And is she going to be able to get Mr. Jin? No. Mr. Jin, Nightmare Robin comes right back and snags the kill. Maestro actually getting locked up here as well. Will Mr. Jin be able to get a leap on top of him? No, can't actually. Oh, never mind. Yes, he can. And I'm going pro with Mr. Punchy, finishing off Maestro, and that is yet another kill for Church of Mal.
I'm going pro. such a big force in every bottom game skirmish. He's continually come down every time there's a lot of action to try to help secure a couple kills. And his Surefire is often just a little bit too late to the party, having to use his abilities more defensively. Meanwhile, oh, up top here, both Nick and Cal. Cal eats a turret shot.
Oh! Ooh. And he's down to just a couple hundred hit points there, but it doesn't look like he's going to be able to survive against that. So he'll back up. He's like, oh, hey, there could be people coming to kill me. Namely, the Flash. And here comes Mecha Malfred. Is he going to dive the turret for it? No, he's not. Cal gets out.
He was hoping that Cal would try to go back and add self-tab. I think Cal saw him coming, or at least predicted his arrival, and played a little bit safer. Of course, it's going to delay his return to the lane, but it's better than being dead, I guess.
And Mecha Malfred picks up the camp up top, so he'll be able to have that vision suppression. And I'm Going Pro has been on point with Mr. Punchy. We saw it in the last game as well. He's able to snag those long-range last-second kills with those and is a force to be reckoned with. I think we've been kind of ignoring the mid laners over the last couple of games because the games have been pretty passive in mid, and they've kind of just been reacting until it gets to late game, and then they're there for team fights. But I'm Going Pro is kind of the unsung hero here. He's ensuring that he's always ahead in credits. Is he here, of course, as soon as I say that? Yeah, he is. And he's looking pretty good.
Oh, Mr. Jin gets sucked in by Nick's ultimate. Unable to really do enough to return damage here. I'm Going Pro just has to be content with staying alive. But the bottom lane, meanwhile, a lot of pressure going down here. I don't know if... and that Maestro actually did go down. Sorry we missed that. Probably a Harley Quinn ultimate followed by Atomic Joker just dishing out his damage. That allowed Team C to get a lot of damage there on the bottom turret.
That's right. We were watching that kill in mid, but that one happened at bot basically at the same time. So the net result is a one for one, basically, even though they were two separate engagements. Now, all the while, Church of Mal has actually done a pretty good job of bringing this gold lead a little bit closer. Never mind. The turret goes down, and it goes right back to where it was before, so I'm a dirty liar. But Church of Mal needs to start watching for objectives. They're kind of letting Team C start to invade their their jungle over and over again. It looks like they're going to try and jump directly on top of Cow. Here comes the ult from the Flash. Not going to do anything, and Mr. Jin is in hot pursuit.
Oh, and here's the second assault on Nick, but Wonder Woman's not an easy target to take down. Can he get enough damage? Oh, there's the camera. There's a jump to it. He's going to be able to escape quite easily. The Raider was called up top, and I wonder, you know, when is the team going to make a big move for it? They're all trying to posture and skirmish, and this is a moment where if anyone gets picked off, it's not just a kill. It's probably a Raider to the other team as well.
Yeah, definitely. And unfortunately, no gas bat in this game to steal it with a bat scream, unfortunately. So, but yeah, and Team C is actually going to take this opportunity to push out mid lane. Bottom turret is under attack. Cow's actually going to rotate down there. His teleport's not up for another 60 seconds, though.
Yeah, so he's going to be missing from the fight along with Maestro. It's just a straight 4-on-4 here. And C is, they're going for the Raider. Mr. Jin was trying to line and wait. There is a camera there, so they have it spotted. They've gotten the Raider down to half life, but here's actually another teleport.
And Maestro's actually coming in right now, but immediately Mecha Malfred dies. He's not able to get up an ult or anything like that as well. Doesn't look like he was actually up and available for that fight, so he was essentially useless. Nick dies off to the side as well. Blocking Bracer's not able to lock up near enough people. And honestly, Picasso is in danger of dying here off to the side. And it looks like Picasso will end up falling. No, down to just a few hit points. Not sure actually where he ran off to. No, he is dead. It was just his passive was up. There we go.
That was such a well-played fight by Team C. What they did there is they knew that Church of Mal was looking for those huge, basically, AoE ultimates. What they did is they tied it backwards and split apart, and both Mecha Malfred and Nick were caught being greedy. They were looking for the massive ultimate, and they waited a hair too long, got caught by too much CC, the Harley Quinn ultimate, and just all the damage from Team C picked them apart. And without those two, you know, AoE ultimates doing their job, or actually without the champions even doing anything beyond dying. Which is kind of a fairly convincing win for seeing that engagement.
And C moves up and they take Raider for free. No problems there. So things are looking pretty good for them. Nick is going to check things out. Oh, well, all right. I guess that happened. He'll back away for the time being.
He gets this camp. That's basically like a Raider, right?
Yeah. Basically, exactly the same. So, so Nick ends up. So, what is his total credit score at right now? He is at 4,600. To Atrocitus, this is 5,100. So he's actually done a fairly decent job. He is second place on his team. It's really Mecha Malfred that's kind of been the one who's equalizing for their team, but was just kind of a non-factor in the last two fights, to be honest.
Yeah, I mean, with Flash, it's one of those things where he's often really good at kind of like running people down and getting kills, but when it comes to a team fight, it's hard if he's the guy going in there first and initiating, because he's either, you know, hit by CC and taken out like in the last fight before he can do anything, or he's forced to burn his ultimate at kind of inopportune times. But he really wants his ultimate to scatter the team, not just to force them to kind of not kill him for a second.
Right. And if there's a situation where Nick can get in and get blocking bracers on him, as Maestro actually is taking a pretty good amount of damage, but he's going to go and I'm going pro, turns around, knocks out Green Arrow. Does Mecha Malfred have enough here? I'm going pro is actually doing some pretty crazy damage.
Oh, the meteor drop hits Mecha Malfred. He tried to dodge an ability with his speed storm, but somehow I'm going pro. Basically won a straight up 1v2 there. And in fact, it can't quite convert it to two kills unless Misogen is able to finish it out, although I do think I'm going pro is taken down as well.
And Sure Jamel's middle turret has been destroyed in the middle of all of that, so this credit advantage does start moving up to 6.4k. Looks like Team C, I'm going pro, did end up getting knocked out there in the fight. Nightmare Superman coming up from around the side, making sure that they can kill him. He's sitting here and just making sure that he can defend this turret. But here comes Kathis from around the side, and Picasso falls immediately.
And you can see right there is one of the big strengths in Nightmare Rob. And if you have someone to help you set up that combo like Hardy with their ultimate, the damage burst Nightmare Robin does is pretty insane if you can get in there close and unleash his full combo.
Yeah, and there was a moment there where if that lasso had actually hit from Nick as he was trying to come in and defend this turret, he could have gotten off blocking bracers, and believe it or not, that would have been a kill. Kathis was caught right under turret fire there. Couldn't grab it, though, was just millimeters away. And looks like Cow gonna drop down that EMP, and that'll be plenty enough to finish up that turret.
Meanwhile, we do see Mecha Malfred going for that split push up top. I think that's what he should be doing. He hasn't really found much impact in his team fights quite yet, so should stick to trying to use his mobility, realizing, okay, we're behind as a team. What we need to do is just find a way to start getting credits, and one of the best ways for Flash to do that for a team is really, really focus on split pushing, because at the very least, he's getting some solo farm in.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, it looks like they're going to be able to get that, but they may give up Raider in return. Cow is taking a pretty significant amount of damage from Leviathan there. Sorry, not Raider, Leviathan, of course. And the rest of Church of Mal just can't contest this. That is actually going to end up being a free Leviathan for Church of Mal. That is huge.
That is. I mean, maybe, actually, might even lose a turret here. Can they get it? Oh, they do get the turret. Cow doesn't quite teleport there in time to save it. But I definitely think C is not too sad about trading the single turret for that levy.
And I'm going pro is trying to make his way around the edge, but Wonder Woman is going to find this. And looks like, yeah, won't be able to directly engage that. She gets a little bit of damage. She's like, that was really cool. Now I gotta leave. Otherwise, he's gonna turn around and kill me.
Joker is one of those targets you don't want to be up close with unless you can really finish him off fast. And actually, there they go to the great ultimate.
And we'll see if Azura Fire is enough to finish this off. I'm going pro is taking a huge amount of damage. He turns back around and starts trying to re-engage. Mecha Malfred did knock out Cow in the middle of that. And looks like that is going to be all. And I'm going pro has fallen. Wow, he did actually fall off to the side. What actually got him? I am so sorry.
So he actually turned around for a second to try to save Cal, dropped the Leviathan core and put out a good amount of damage, but then Azure Fire just hit him with one skier.
Oh, okay, that's all it was. All right, I just didn't see what the finishing blow was. He was just there 1 second and then he wasn't. But yeah, so I'm going pro falls as well, and that's exactly what Church of Mal needed. There was an 11k credit advantage, now it's down to about 7k, and they're gonna continue to try and press their advantage. Maestro going toe-to-toe with Sotura, that's not gonna work out well for him. Oh, but he does actually get saved by Nightmare Superman. Really nice job as Kadem comes down and Maestro is going to be able to sneak away.
That was a really big play. I feel like Picasso's made a lot of those throughout this game to help all those bomb lane engagements coming with a shield or an ultimate just in time. Really showcasing the strength of Nightmare Superman, and he's really building a very mobile Nightmare Superman. I mean, his first items past his initial Gambit and Nilring have been the Omelette of Isis and a Speed Force battery. Mm-hmm. So he's going purely for mobility to try to make sure he can be where he needs to be to make those plays.
And it's worked out. I mean, obviously, Nightmare Superman, even though he'll add so much to your team, he's never going to be the leader in credits. In fact, a lot of times he's going to be almost all the way down the list.
Unless you're Cow.
Unless you're Cow, of course, and then you just 1v2 people and win.
Yeah.
But you know, and when he's playing that conventional controller role, I mean, he's not going to rack up the greatest amount of credits. He's never going to be present in that many kills. And so you think, well, what is his utility? That's what it is. He keeps your team alive. He can turn that around and he can suppress targets and knock them out very easily. So this is kind of a great coming out party for Nightmare Superman, if you want to call it that, in terms of versatile use.
looks like Nick's trying to set up an ambush here. There's really no vision on him. I think they suspect he's there, though, as there's a lot of positioning around this Raider as actually, this doesn't come up to the minute 30, so
yeah.
I guess it's just like the positioning to try to get vision on it to make sure that, you know, when it does come up, people have good eyes on it. And, oh, Nick was spotted out, and this is not looking good for him.
And at the same time, I'm Going Pro actually knocked out Maestro down to the bot lane, too. So two separate kills there. I'm Going Pro just chasing Maestro down, and not much you can do about that. Man, I'm Going Pro now level 14, has to have massive credits at the moment. Yeah, 8,300, 532. Yes, he's been picked. Excuse me, I'm so sorry. Picked off a couple of times, but his Mr. Punchies have been on point, and he has been rocking face with damage.
I mean, the reason he's been picked off a couple of times is because he's been making very bold plays. Like right now, he's attracting attention of multiple Church of Mal members. He's way behind enemy lines, but he's just trying to, you know, allow these other, the rest of his team to do what they need to do. And he somehow escaped that. It was like three. It looked
like kidding me.
Zatanna, Flash, and Nightmare Superman were trying to corner him. And he's like, no, I'm a Joker. He just kind of, you know, puts up illusions and presence everywhere, and eventually, you know, finagles his way out of there. And the rest of his team is able to take out one turret, probably a second one here, unless, oh no, Nick's ultimate must be on cooldown.
Yeah. And in fact, he may end up paying for this, as I'm Going Pro's going to come in from the side. He still has quite a bit of damage. Picasso throws off his ult as well to try and hold Team Z back, and it looks like it will, at least temporarily. But as we saw there, Church of Mal has no ability to contest Team Z at the moment.
No, I mean, the positioning of Team Z is or in the rotations are basically finding openings, or even when there's no opening, they create one by either using I'm Going Pro or Cow as kind of their main... they're main people who kind of form a great distraction sphere somewhere, despite by making some big plays either top lane or bottom lane.
Now that that credit advantage has actually extended almost to 11k once again for Team C, and it looks like they're going to be able to get another free raider. Will Church of Mal come up and contest this? No, they are nowhere in sight.
Yeah, there's only a couple of them here in the middle. If they went up there, it would probably not go so well for them. And you know, part of what made this so easy for C is, well, one is they just took down the top. Two top turrets and put a lot of pressure there, so Church of Mal is a little bit defensive. But also, remember, about a minute 30 ago, they had gone through and destroyed all the vision from Church of Mal and set up their own. And they use things like X-ray vision, they use things like the ECM burst on Mr. Terrific's team mask to kind of reveal all those cameras. And again, I'm Going Pro off on his own, but...
But you know, honestly, every time he's gone off on his own, he's like, with the exception of this one, because he doesn't have a kill yet, but he went off, snagged a kill, and allowed his team to take an objective. I think they'll take him dying every time for that.
Yeah.
Cow actually gets lassoed, but Nick has no ability to follow that up.
Oh, and Maestro coming with a great angle. I'm Going Pro does help.
Are you kidding me? And he's still alive? And it looks like Maestro's gonna end up paying for this. Oh my god, he came up and all he had to do was walk up to Joker and just kind of tap him on the shoulders and he would have fallen over dead.
I mean, what happened there is Maestro got Joker with the ultimate, so Joker had almost no life.
Right.
And then Maestro's like, okay, Flash has got this. I can go try to focus on surviving and dealing with Atrocitus. And Flash didn't have it.
Nope, no, not at all. So Mecha Malfred and Maestro end up falling, and this is going to be a dampener for Team C.
Yeah, use of the EMP there, but now the EMP's gone. And actually, well, Nick and great ultimate there, but a second EMP really neutralizing the effectiveness of ultimate quite a bit.
That's right, Denazer Fire takes huge damage. Looks like he just barely avoids death off to the side, but he's going to be a non-factor in this fight. This should allow C to come back, do a few more shots here to the dampener, and just clean it up.
Yeah, taking a couple shots at the end there. That was really well done. I thought when Nick came in there with that big ultimate, that would have been it. But Hardy both disrupted that ultimate almost instantly. And then, of course, they dropped the second EMP, realizing that, you know, there was a big play attempted to be made there.
Oh, and unfortunately, Miss Jen trying to knock down McAlfred. He is actually going to die. And it has been quite a while since Church of Mal has been able to pick up a kill. So we'll see if they can string together a couple more here. But Team C is knocking on the door of a second damper.
It is a 4v5. But, I mean, Team C is ahead so much that they just straight out win this 4v5.
Yeah.
Cal taking a lot of turret damage. But now the damper goes down. Nick, no Wonder Woman ultimate available there, and it looks like Church of Mal is forced back. I don't think, is C just going to go for the third dampener right now, or are they going to?
Oh, I don't know. That's rough. I mean, maybe, but it's still another 20 seconds before Misogen comes up. maybe they're just strong enough that they can contest this and they can take it out just because they feel like it, but I think they have to fall back from this.
Yeah, we did see Cal go back. He had taken quite a bit of turret fire, and I think they're all going to back up saying, you know, maybe we could force it, but a lot of our credit advantage isn't being realized until we actually go back and buy from having all those kills and the dampers we just took down. It also does a levy up too, so
yeah.
It seems like a safer objective to take, and there's no way Church Mouse is going to be able to contest this.
Oh, especially once I'm going pro gets here and the amount of damage that he puts out. It's just crazy. Cal now going to start tanking Leviathan. It looks like they're going to be able to grab this once again. That's going to put us at a 17.5k credit advantage. And Team C is dominating.
Yeah, this looks like a very, very rough game for Church of Mao. They're down by, like you said, a ridiculous amount of credits. And C now has all the Leviathan deployables. And unlike their game versus Brawl, where they had a hard time finishing off because they had no one to really run in there and initiate, they have Kyle who can, you know, run in there and then be that big presence that kind of forces Church of Mao then to both either work around Cal or focus on him, and whichever one they do, the rest of his team is going to be free to lay out the damage.
Totally. So the itemization for I'm Going Pro is crazy right now. At 11.5k credits, he is almost finished with 5 items, and he is pointlessly powerful right now.
Yeah, he's got his modded cosmic staff, and he's got his Marauder ring done, and he's got his Starheart done. So the burst, I mean, we've seen it when he's dueling Flash. He just basically two shots Flash with his abilities, and it's just going to get worse. I mean, pretty much no one but Wonder Woman can actually survive even a single Mr. Punchy at this point. So we'll see what they can do. He's very confident going off on his own because Joker's one of those guys that the whole team converges on him. His ultimate and his presence have so much area effect damage that he just can't take him out.
And even if you get around all of that area effect damage and stuff like that, he just walks away a good portion of the time. Yeah. All right, so it looks like they're going to ult directly on top of Satura. Blocking Bracers does actually trap everyone in against Nick, but he has now caught out all alone, and he is going to fall. Off to the side, it looks like Azure Fire may end up falling too. Church of Mount Picasso, no! He ends up going down onto the side. Maestro tries to come in to get a little bit more damage. That's not going to be enough. Azure Fire off to the side as well. And that, ladies and gentlemen, actually just be GG. That is a team kill. There was 1 minute up. And I think Team C is going to be able to push through and just win their first game.
Yeah, that team fight, I mean, Nick got in there and did an amazing ultimate, but no one else was able to get to the back line. The whole rest of the team was distracted with Cal, and then I'm Going Pro came in there. They needed, you know, Mecha Alfred to go in there with Nick. And maybe they chained the ultimates, they maybe could have gone Satura, but as is, you can have the greatest Wonder Woman ultimate ever, but if the rest of your team can't get past Cal, or I'm Going Pro, she can't take the other three on her own.
Yep, exactly. So there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. Team C is going to take game number one here, and I got to hand it all-star that one. Not Cow. Cow did a great job in the last couple of games. He was the all-star of the last two games. That's going to I'm Going Pro. I mean, the way he was able to chase people down, the advantage he got himself in lane, he knew to rotate to bot lane every single time they wanted to try and pick up a kill, so really well done by him.
Yeah, his rotations are great, and even, I mean, at a certain point, he started getting ahead, and then he saw I'm Going Pro just run to the bottom lane, and two people tried to get him. It was both Maestro and Mecha Alfred, and he basically killed them both. And then I think Picasso came in and finished him off, but the fact that one guy, it takes three people from the enemy team to actually corner him down and take him out, it's his movements with Joker, his ability to kind of juke skills, and also land his own skills, is it really, I think, was the biggest part of his success in that game.
Yeah, you said it took three people to get him, but that only happened once. The other two times they sent three people to get him, he just walked away.
That's
so
true.
All right, that's game number one. Of course, this is a best of three, so Team C is just one game away from taking that $1,000 top prize here at the Go4IC Monthly NA.